Advising you now, I have a 6-year-old instead of a 12-year-old. 6-year-old girl, abdominal injuries.
Okay, so you've got at least 2 injured?
Yeah, there's one guy laying in the ditch. I don't think he's breathing. No, he's dead.
Well, the 2017 documentary Church of Felons putting a spotlight on extreme levels of addiction in the region, specifically Western Wisconsin. The film follows 4 recovering addicts looking for a second chance after a life of crime. And Church of Felons is a debut feature film for Osceola, Wisconsin native Jordan Mederick, and he joins us live here at 4 o'clock. Thank you so much
for
joining us.
Thank you very much, Brian.
I know this is a project that you're really, really passionate about. When I hear you talk about it, what made you want to make the film?
Yeah, so, you know, this film follows 4 multi-offense felons within Wisconsin who have lived a life of addiction and crime, and it kind of follows their whole life of, you know, what the costs are leading up to that. And it begs the question, do second chances exist? And so really, I made this film as my portrayal of my answer to that question. Is, you know, whether or not someone can find life after crime and after addiction. Is there a life after that? And so it really, that's the whole purpose is that. I found that people are so encouraged when they hear stories of hope and second chances, and that's what this film really is questioning.
And you say it's really an epidemic, addiction right here in our region, and you say it's almost kind of underneath the surface. A lot of us aren't actually noticing that it's going on.
Yeah, addiction is the great American epidemic, without a second thought. You know, in Wisconsin, there is no minimum drinking age. It's the statute 125.01A. Children of any age can purchase and consume alcohol within vicinity of their parent. Opiates, you know, fentanyl overdoses are on the rise. It's costing all of us dearly. Everyone who's watching this now, you and me, we're all directly impacted by addiction right now.
And you're going to be tomorrow, I know, showing this film in Hastings at the high school there, I believe. What are you hoping students there that watch this really take away with them?
Right. So, yeah, this is a public screening. It's that we've had multiple large-scale sold-out screenings all throughout Wisconsin, Michigan, and here in Minnesota as well. And so it really says that there's people dying for hope, for second chances. They want to know that there is hope. And so I want people to come there to have their eyes open, to realize that this is reality everywhere. And it is, it's just hiding, as you mentioned, underneath the surface. But I think we can do better. I think Minnesota can do better. Wisconsin can do a whole lot better for sure. We need the help, we need influence, we need people who can use their power for good to do so.
Sure. So you mentioned public screening tomorrow. If people can't make it to that, how can they see the film? Are there ways out there for people to actually view it?
Yes, we do have the DVD, you know, available online as well. We're slated for acquisition on Netflix, we're hoping, so we're crossing fingers.
That'd be big.
But certainly seeing it in the live context, we're going to have people who are featured in the film actually speaking live at the event in a Q&A session, so people can ask these people who are in it to talk about it. And so the live format is the best version for sure, but it's you know, it's certainly a growing grassroots movement of second chances.
And I love that you say the message coming out of it really is about hope, really an uplifting message, hopefully for people to turn their lives around, right, that might be struggling with this stuff. Thank you so much for coming by. We hope the event goes well tomorrow.
Absolutely. Thank you,
Brian. I appreciate it. For much more on this film, if you want to learn more about it, Church of Felons and the Second Chance Movement, go to care11.com, go to shows, and then the news at 4 o'clock. Let's go out to the